I'm Gabby LaRue, Interim Secretary General of the Trade Union for Musicians of South Africa, TUMSA. In the email that we sent to you this afternoon, Friday the 21st of August 2020, we promised that we will make this little instructional video just to give you as a member a slightly better chance of being successful in your application for the second wave of COVID-19 funding by the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture. Before I do that, I want to say to you that TUMSA, as an organization and as a labor union, is once again very, very disappointed at the out-of-touch manner with which this application process was introduced once again. The methods suggested once again will narrow it down to a very small group who have access to resources that will make it easier for them to do this application successfully, where the vast majority of our members will find it difficult to do this strictly online application and to upload all the documents required in time to be successful by the deadline. However, we're going to do our best to assist our members as far as possible to do the process as it is required at the moment. But next week, from Monday, we will also join other organizations to appeal to the department to make other methods available for handing in applications in this regard, rather than only online. The suggestion at the moment is perhaps that our members throughout the country will be able to hand in hard copy application forms to their local municipal offices in the cities, towns, and villages in their area. We think that that may be another method that will be more inclusive of all of our members. However, right now, I'm going to take you directly to the website of the National Arts Council, who is handling this round of distribution of COVID-19 relief funds. We will start at the website of the Department of Arts and Culture. So you'll type in dac.gov.za. Scroll down until you get to the sentence COVID-19 Sport, Arts and Culture Relief Fund, Second Wave Online Application. That'll take you directly to the next page, where once again you click on COVID-19 Arts and Culture Relief Fund Second Wave. Careful, because the one below is for sports relief. You don't want to be there. You want to be on COVID-19 Arts and Culture Relief Fund Second Wave, as the arrow suggests to you there. And that link will take you directly to the National Arts Council website, but specifically to their grant management system. And you'll land on this page. If you've never been registered, then you'll click on the register button. If you have registered before, you'll put your username in there with your password, and then you'll click on login. If you have forgotten your password, click on forgot password, and it'll be sent to you via the email address that you submitted when you first registered. Now, if you're registering for the first time, you'll go to the following page. You'll put your first name in there, your surname, your email address, and then your email address again to verify it. Please don't forget to verify your email address. So put it in there and there. Then they'll ask you a small mathematical question. Yeah, if you're not good at maths, ask someone to do that maths for you. Please remember, this is an example, so don't use any of this in your application. The one that you'll receive will be fresh. You'll put the answer to the little question there, and you'll click on register. You will then go to this page, and it will show you immediately your username will come up there and your password will be issued to you. Very important, write that password down somewhere or put it in your phone or put it somewhere we'll know where it is, because you're going to need it to log in every single time. Otherwise, you're going to forget your password and every time you'll have to send an email to get your password again. All right. So, Now that you've registered, you can click on login and you'll click login there. Very importantly, this funding is not the only funding project that is available on this website. There are three, but the one you need is the year 2020 DSAC relief funding, and you have to click on that green button. So this page will come up and then you'll see the three projects are listed here. The one that we are applying for is the one at the bottom, number three, year 2020 relief funding, year 2020 DSAC relief funding, and you'll see the arrow, the red arrow is pointing there. You won't see that arrow when you open it up, but just know you have to click on the
the green cross, that's the third one from the top. There are three, click on the bottom one. That is the correct funding project. You will then go to the next page, and then you start filling in your details. It will confirm your name and the funding window. In other words, it will say the project type will be there, and then it will say your name there. It will put your name in there automatically. And then here you'll say register application, or if you come to this point and you want to cancel, you'll just click cancel. But very importantly, from this moment on, you have to save every time. You have to keep saving. So once you click on register application, then you will be faced with these three sections. And every time you can click on a section, but before you move to another section, very important that you save. Because otherwise, when you go back, you'll have to fill it all in again. All right.
So fill in your specific art form. In our case, in Tumsa, it will be music, which means you tick this music box over here. Also, then make sure that you tick the box which indicates your preferred method of communication. If you want email or SMS, you'll just indicate it over here.
So click on section one. It will take you to section one, application details. It will start appearing here, and then you start putting your information in. Keep on saving all the time. If you've left something out before you go to the next window, it will tell you in red here that before you can submit your application, the following fields will need to be completed. So you'll see in red, it will tell you if you've left something out that you may have forgotten. But before you move to the next section, make sure you save. Section two, applicant details. Now you carry on with all of your details. It will ask you many, many questions there. Fill in as much as you can, but save before moving to the next section. Guys, don't forget to save. So here's some very important advice. If you see there are documents that the department's asking for, you know, like tax clearance certificates or tax certificates or bank statements or whatever, and you don't have those, don't roll over and lie down and say, oh, well, no, I'm not going to qualify. If you've been working for cash payments or whatever the sake may be, and maybe you don't have a tax account because you've never been above the threshold where you know you have to pay tax, and you didn't think that you needed a tax certificate, but you do, that's news to you, but you can't be punished for that now. So us as organizations, we're going to urge the department to consider all applications, even if some of them don't have those required documents where they are just unrealistic. Bank statements, many of the musicians don't even have bank accounts, yet they've been active. So if you can have your posters with dates on where you performed at venues, and you can get a letter from the venue owner there or the manager, no, listen, Temba played here, I know him, he's regular, but we closed now for lockdown or whatever. Any such documentation that you can get, upload your videos, your playlists, your cue sheets, your stuff that you've submitted to SAMRO for your performances and SAMPRA, those things, all of that must be considered as evidence. And if you do have bank statements, get those, send them in. If you don't have a tax certificate, look, try and get one. Go to the tax office nearest to you and explain your situation and try and get a tax clearance certificate. Tell them that you're well below the tax paying threshold. Take your ID with you, show them, and if you can get a tax clearance certificate, you've got a whole week to do it. So just take the trouble and go and do it. Don't just roll over and say, oh, it's not fair, now the qualifications are too hectic. Do your best and try and get as much as possible, okay? We will try and engage with the department and get them to be a bit more in touch with the reality of musicians. It's the same mistake that they did the first time, they're making it again. But we're going to try our best to urge them and to try and get through to them this time. You, from your side, do your best to get whatever proof you can get. Put that in, get those documents scanned, write letters, sign them, get them scanned, and submit them. Just submit them. We will try our best to do the rest. Okay? That's very important advice that I'm giving you. Let's continue. Section 3, upload section, read the instructions of what is required. Take note that only certain document types can be uploaded. These are highlighted in yellow below for you. So doc, docx, those are your normal Word documents. PDF is the Adobe PDF. JPEG as a picture. Zip, if you want to zip all your documents together and you want to upload a zip file, it'll take that. PNGs are those transparent ones. XLX are normally spreadsheets. So the website is pretty clued up. It'll take most of those formats of documents. If you want to submit a link to your video or your audio or whatever, you can post those links here. And then you click on save. The reason why I'm saying this is, like I explained to you, that this time they give us a little bit more flexibility to prove that we are music practitioners. They will be able to see, oh no, this person definitely is. This is a professional. It's most likely this guy is not trying to cheat, or this lady is not trying to pull the wool over our eyes. They're really legitimate music practitioners in the industry. All right. So then you fill all of those details in here. You continue, and then once your things are in, you click on upload. All right. So if your documents are here, you've pulled your documents in here, or you've pulled your links in here for your videos, or you've pulled your SoundCloud links in here, or whatever, then you press upload. So once you've uploaded your documents or your video links or your audio links or references or anything like that, this is the section to do it in, and you click on upload. The terms and conditions, validation and submission, at the top right of each page, just below the section name, you will see the following buttons. Terms and conditions, validate, submit, save. So the validate button checks for any missing information on your form. So validate. You can click it at any stage of the application process. Click the close on the bottom of the validation page to get back to your form. So if you want to check, listen, have I got my stuff together here? Just click on validate. All right. And then once you're ready to submit, you click submit or you press save. But just save as many times as you can. The terms and conditions, if you click on there, the terms and conditions, it'll bring this page up. You've got to read through them and you've got to click in that little box. Tick that little box, I accept the above terms and conditions, and then you click on accept. Then you'll close it, and then you'll go back to, you know, the normal document. All right. You must read all the terms and conditions, otherwise they won't allow you to continue. Submission, only after you've clicked the terms and conditions and validate that no data is missing, can you submit your form. So in other words, this little button here will not work unless you've first done the terms and conditions acknowledgement, which is this one, you've accepted it, and you've clicked on the validate button, and there's no red writing that's coming up to say you've forgotten to give this or you've forgotten to give that or whatever. If nothing comes up, it will validate you. Once you've done that, then you'll be able to click on submit, and you go for it. You send, and off you go. And that is the end of your application. All right. So a couple of things. You're back with me. So the one thing I want to say to you is that if you look at the attachment that we sent to you in the email, you'll see that there are certain things, like, for instance, they ask for a tax certificate or a tax clearance certificate, etc. Many of you probably have never been to a tax office. Many of you will never pay tax because you earn so little. You earn below the threshold for people to pay tax. But you still must register as a tax payer or non-payer. You need to get a tax number. Now, we understand that this is going to be problematic to get this before the deadline, which is literally in about 10 days' time from today. So we're going to appeal to the department next week. If they insist on getting tax certificates or tax clearances, then they have to make that facility available. Either they must make the deadline further, or they must make a plan with the tax department that thousands of musicians are suddenly going to turn up there next week to try and get a tax certificate. That's not fair. So this is another flaw of this application process that we feel is not fair and not practical. Because last time they asked for the same thing. Thousands of musicians couldn't go to the tax department because of lockdown. So it was impossible to do that. Only those few that are already were tax registered would have been able to apply. And these are the type of flaws that our ministry and our department is out of touch with. They don't understand. If a person just survives on hand to mouth, getting cash from a gig here and a gig there and getting cash, tax doesn't come into it. So we're not saying it's right or it's wrong for our musicians to not be taxpayers. But in a time like this, it's not the time to punish them for not being registered with the Department of Revenue. So please bear with us, because if you don't have that, then maybe that's going to be problematic. But we're going to try and get around that by the appeals that we're going to make to the department next week. What we're going to do also is to suggest to them, and I mentioned that earlier, that you will be able to, rather than having to scan your documents and upload them on that website, which many of you will find it very, very hard to do, to get somewhere where there's a scanner, to convert the documents to the right format, then to upload them and all of that. Many of you will be unfamiliar with that. And frankly, to do that on a mobile phone is going to be very, very difficult. A lot of the internet cafes have either closed down or they still won't be open. Some of them may be open, but still, the amount of people that are going to apply for this relief is going to make it a big, big challenge within the next week to get that done. So we're going to try and appeal to them to try and relax the requirement that it can only be done online. If we can get them to arrange with the municipalities in all the main cities and towns and villages, that you can simply fill in your application forms, the same data, the same qualifications, things that you've seen, that we've told you in the video. You know, if you can get that done, if you can somehow at least just download those documents, look, if you can download it, an attachment from an email, that's already a sign that you are actively online. So they may say, but why can they download the attachments, but they can't upload the attachments to the National Arts Council? So these are the type of things that we're going to have to deal with as your union. And we want you to understand, it's not easy, because the department essentially are not talking to us. They're now not even talking to some of the other departments that they tried to get us to talk to in the first place. They're now going through the National Arts Council. Now, it is said that there's a helpline available and it's operating in different languages. That's great. If that works, it's great. And that's the type of support that we will support. But for you guys who have got to apply for this, it's going to be a tough week this next week, guys. But don't give up. Make sure you walk the walk, you pick up the challenge, and you do this. If you don't have all the documentation, do what you can do. Get as much information as you can. If you performed at a couple of gigs last year and there were online banners with your name on it and whatever, and there's a venue, or if you can get a letter from a tavern or a restaurant or a bar where you played, if you know the manager there and you can get them just to write you an email to say, yeah, Johnny or Temba played here, or Lindy West, she did do some gigs for us there last year. We paid them in cash or whatever. If you can get that, all of that is going to help make your application stronger. Get as much information as you can get, because you improve your chances. All right. So that should be it for now. Please, we're going to be writing a lot more emails this coming week. It's going to be like the first time around where they were coming sort of sometimes twice a day. All right. Because we want to consult with you guys and make sure you are informed as much as possible. So we're going to keep you informed. But in the meantime, go through that thing. Don't fill it in the first time. Just go through the different steps. Go through the different steps. Check it out carefully. And then once you're ready, start filling it in. All right? Remember to save your password. Once you register on that site at the National Arts Council, save your password somewhere. Don't forget your password. Okay? Remember? And then, as you go to the different sections, remember to save every time. Otherwise, if you go back there, you have to fill everything in again. As you move through the sections, make sure you save and save again. All right. And then right there at the end, remember, click on the terms and conditions button, make sure you accept that, and then click on the validate button to make sure that there's no documents outstanding that it needs, that it requires in some of those places where you've got to fill in your details. Once there's none of that, then it will take you to the submit page, to the save page, and you submit and upload what you've got. And then I'm afraid it's no longer in our hands or in your hands. It's then up to those who are going to be looking at that application to decide or not decide. So that's it. Dear TUMSA members, thank you for your patience and your courage and your strength. We truly have done whatever we can to be of assistance to you so far. We're not charging you a membership fee yet because we know you simply can't afford to pay that. We're struggling ourselves. I can't lie to you. We've been funding this whole thing from our pockets and just trying to keep it going as well as what we can. We set up the website for you. We're making sure that we're getting registration of the union. It is with the Department of Labor, of Employment and Labor. So we'll keep you posted there as well. But thank you for being a TUMSA member. We will not let you down. Stand shoulder to shoulder. We're not somehow the leaders and you the followers. All of us are together in this as one. We're standing shoulder to shoulder together. We will take this union forward to become a mighty voice for the people, for the working musicians of this country, so that we don't go back to the normal before COVID. That wasn't an acceptable normal. After COVID, we want to take this to a new normal that will give you an opportunity to be a professional music practitioner, a music worker who can be proud that they are regular, they're working in a regulated society with proper protection and job protection against exploitation from whatsoever quarter. All right. Thanks for listening to me babbling on. I hope you got some value. And please make sure that you send your questions, your text messages, or your voice clips to this number that will appear on your screen now. From my side, Gabby LaRue, Amandla, Aluta Continua. We will not give up. We will win this battle. Good night.